you for joining us. Today we are starting our week-long 10th anniversary celebrations. Thank you so much for joining us. And just a brief, Lamakaan was opened on 13th of March 2010, and we are celebrating our 10th anniversary this year. Lamakaan is Hyderabad's inclusive open cultural space devoted to promotion of inclusiveness, liberal ideas through literature, music, performance, discussions, theater workshops, exhibitions, talks, etc. So this year in 2019, we had had 85 plays, 22 art shows, 70 workshops, 35 music, dance, poetry events, 125 talks, meetings, discussions, 51 Bazme Sukhan events, 50 organic bazaars, 12 quiz, and 86 movie and documentary screenings. Thank you so much, and we have a beautiful lineup of events this coming 6 days. So please join us for whichever event you can. Thank you so much.
Hello everybody, welcome to Lamakaan for the 10th anniversary. It's so good to see a big crowd, and I'd like to invite Sumangala Damodaran over here. She will present a event, Resistance Music as Politics. Sumangala will present through music some examples of how music has been used to articulate resistance to existing social and political order in different parts of the country from 1940s to the present. Attempt is to point towards the aesthetic as well as the political social dimensions of the music of resistance of our country, and also situated in terms the influences that have been pivotal in the emergence of music. She teaches developmental studies and popular music studies at Ambedkar University. And along with her, Mark Arana is a guitarist, composer, educator, and researcher from New Delhi. He has 20 years of experience playing guitar in a variety of genres, including Latin, R&B, pop rock, and metal. In recent years, he has been working on incorporating guitar with various Indian and South African musical styles. Mark has recently completed a research master's in ethnomusicology from the University of Cape Town, South Africa. In 2018, he co-directed a live art performance, Aif and Bilal, combining research outputs of his colleagues from the project Recentering Afro-Asia. Apart from his own projects, Mark currently plays guitar for Sushmit Sen Chronicles and Sumangala Damodaran. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you very much for this wonderful invitation, and it's such a privilege to be here. I have heard of Lamakaan before, and I've only heard about it being a wonderful cultural space. And for me, it's very, very special because I spent 10 years of my childhood in Hyderabad. So, formative years, school years, I spent in Hyderabad. So coming to Hyderabad is always special, but coming to perform is particularly special for several reasons. One is that whatever relationship I have with politics, a lot of it actually got formed in Hyderabad, in my home as well as outside. But then it's only when I've come back here as an adult and as a gray-haired person that I've actually registered what used to happen, around my home and various other venues when I witnessed the unfolding of a lot of politics as a child. And so it's an immense privilege to be here, and thank you very much for inviting me and Mark to perform here. I did not really plan how this performance is going to go because I really wanted to play it by the ear and see what people would be interested in over here. But as the introduction briefly mentioned, what I want to try and do, and this is something that is really also getting thrown up by the times, is that, you know, we are living in times where which are terrible at one level, but we are also living in times which are rejuvenating in a very different kind of a way. For many of us who were afraid that the country had lost its conscience, I mean, the last 2 or 3 months have actually been so invigorating in terms of everything that has happened in terms of the world of politics and in terms of protest politics. So, it is also easy. I'm saying this over here because I know that there are a lot of people who would understand all of this much better than I do, perhaps. I'm saying this over here. What I'm saying is that it is also easy for us to retreat into a certain kind of a comfort where, because resistance and the obvious avenues as well as the venues of resistance are throwing up so much creativity, and there is that whole high of the moment, so to say, that we might actually not reflect a little bit on what it means, apart from the moment itself. So what I want to do today is to sing some pieces which can help us perhaps remember, and also in order to be able to point out to aspects of the creative process that do not directly speak politics. So both the aesthetic dimensions as well as the political dimensions of what might be a protest song, and you know, to try. Of course, it's a very tall task to be able to actually encapsulate what happened from the 1940s until now, and I don't even want to pretend that I'll do that. But what I'm going to try and do is to try and to point towards various aspects that have been taken up by poets and musicians to talk politics, whether directly or not. I'm going to start from 1919. 1919, as we know, was the year that Jallianwala Bagh happened. And last year, we commemorated 100 years of the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, and Chandrasekhar Azad, the Bhim Army leader, when he visited Shaheen Bagh soon after he was released from jail, what he said is that Azadi se pehle Jallianwala Bagh aur Azadi ke baad Shaheen Bagh. But I think one vital difference was that the women of Shaheen Bagh did not allow Shaheen Bagh to become Jallianwala Bagh, and that is what has really, really, been one of the most poignant moments, I think, in our history, one of the most challenging political moments in our history, when a big group of women have just not allowed the state to do what it dreams of doing, which is to shoot them down. So, in honor of all the women all across the country who are really protesting against the state, I want to sing this song that was written after the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. And it was written by an unknown poet, and it used to be sung in the early 1940s by the Indian People's Theatre Association's central squad, which was positioned in Bombay. And this song used to be sung by somebody called Preeti Sarkar, later on Preeti Banerjee, who then became a very prominent singer as well as an actress in Calcutta. So this song I learned from Preeti Banerjee when she was over 80 years old. And it is one of the songs that was forgotten, but I have had the privilege of rediscovering and performing it. Preeti Sarkar was just about 18 or 19 years old when she started singing this song, and the central squad of the IPTA in Bombay consisted of all kinds of stalwarts Salil Chaudhary, Ravi Shankar, Ali Akbar Khan, Jyotirindra Moitra, Reba Roy Chaudhary, and it was a galaxy really of artists of all kinds. And Ravi Shankar is reported to have said about Preeti Sarkar that at that point she was one of the best singers in the country.
Jana
दिन खून के हमारे The next song is from Bengal. It is the form which is called the Bhatiali. And the Bhatiali is the boatman's song. And this is a song called Bundhu. The meaning is obvious, friend. And this is just a call to the friend on the other side of the river, asking the river, asking the friend that, you know, it is this river that unites us, but it's this river which also divides us. And can we really talk about whether we are, if we have the same river, do we belong to different sects? Do we belong to different segments? Aren't we all the same? Aren't you my friend? So this is a Bhatiali that has been sung by another great stalwart of the Ipta from Bengal, called Nirmalendu Chaudhary. And he, among many others, from the 1930s or 40s onwards, actually went out in search of what people's music is. And this idea that the music of protest, the music of the fight against the British, did not only consist of agitational songs, but it also meant discovering what this nation is about, who the people of the country are. And so the Bhatiali as a form was employed by Nirmalendu Chaudhary a lot, to the extent that he came to be known as one of Bengal's best Bhatiali singers, although I don't think he belonged to the community himself. So this is a Bhatiali by Nirmalendu Chaudhary.
लौहर दोरियार बुके रोइलाम सपारिया कि दुख बुझिबो बंधुरे
Early 1940s, as many of us would know, saw a very major event in British India, which killed more than 3 million people, the Bengal famine. And the Bengal famine and the Second World War were two of the big events that shook up the conscience of the country. And it also shook up the conscience of a large number of artists who responded to both these events in very significant ways through their art. the Bengal famine happened in Bengal and in neighboring states. There was one part of the country, not just one part of the country, but you know, many parts of the country which were shielded from the devastating impact of the famine. But Punjab in particular had a specific role to play, which was that Punjab could have provided grain to the people who were dying in the famine, and it slowly started coming to be known that this was a famine that was created by the British. It was not a crisis of production, but it was a crisis of availability. And the politics that the British were playing between the provinces of Punjab and Bengal was such that the food grain could not be transported. So at the peak of the Bengal famine, the Kisan Sabha, the All India Kisan Sabha, called a very big rally of peasants in Lahore in order to be able to talk to the peasants of Punjab about what was happening to those who were their brothers and sisters in Bengal. But this was also a time when a lot of the leaders of the peasant movement were underground, and they could not openly appear. So songs were used as a camouflage, in a way in which, in between, as songs were playing out on the stage, the people who were supposed to make speeches would quietly enter, make their speeches, and then disappear as another song would be sung. I'm going to sing a heer that was written by Sheila Bhatia about the Bengal famine. And it is an unusual song because most of the songs about the Bengal famine are in Bangla. There are a few in Hindi and Urdu as well. And, you know, there is one song in Malayalam, I think. But to find a song on the Bengal famine in Punjabi was very, very surprising for me. And this, I came upon this song from the person who sang it in that particular rally, someone called Swatantrata Prakash. She was born in, when her mother was in jail, and that's why she was called Swatantrata. And she was a very well-known artist. At that point, she was, again, somebody in her late teens. She was an artist, a classical singer. And after partition, she moved to Delhi from Lahore, and along with Kamala Devi Chattopadhyay and various others, was one of the people who revived the Indian handicraft tradition. So Swatantrata ji, again, was in her 80s when I came upon this song from her. And she told me that it was a heer that was written by Sheila Bhatia, and Sheila Bhatia was very well known for using the heer form, you know, to write songs in her various plays as well. And this song, of course, Swatantrata ji could not sing it by the time I met her. She had lost her singing voice. And so this is a song that I have reconstructed with help from Madan Gopal Singh, the Sufi singer. So this is a heer about the Bengal famine. It's a story of a young girl who's lost everything in the famine. She's wandering around, in her own words, like a mad woman, and she does not know what to do because she's lost everything.
Kinu phol dasa dukh dard saiyo kinu phol dasa dukh dard saiyo mera rog tala ilaaj dise karkat sai kanu chuthe main tho क्यों सवाल है बिना जवाब दिसे जवाब दिसे
द नेक्स्ट टू सॉन्ग्स बिलोंग टू तेलंगाना हैदराबाद बट परहैप्स नॉट ओनली हैदराबाद तेलंगाना द फर्स्ट वन इज was written sometime in the 50s or 60s. I'm not very sure about the name of the poet who wrote it. It's a song, I'm not going to translate over here. it's in Telugu, it's called Lagara Hailesa Lagara. It's about, people have probably heard it, right? Yeah, so it's about a road worker who has left everything, has had to leave the village in a state of indebtedness and has moved to the city. I in fact learned this song when I was a child in Hyderabad, and it was taught to me by a teacher in the Jawahar Bal Bhavan. Now I have no idea why she taught us this song, because it was a most unusual song to be taught to children who were learning Carnatic music, but anyway. But and then I discovered what a powerful song it is. Please sing along.
La sagara lagara lagara hailessa lagara lagara hailessa lagara rodu rolaru mundadu gai sagara lagara hailessa lagara lagara hailessa lagara rodu rolaru mundadu gai sagara lagara hailessa lagara rodu rolaru mundadu gai sagara
people in Delhi sing it with me ha so you better sing it
నడినెత్తిన సూరేడు నకనకలాడించాడు నడినెత్తిన సూరేడు నకనకలాడించాడు కంకర రస్తాలో సగమింకా మిగిలున్నది లాగరా హోయ్ లాగరా లాగరా హైలెస్స లాగరా రోడు రోలరు ముందడు గై సాగరా లాగరా హైలెస్స లాగరా రోడు రోలరు ముందడు గై సాగరా రోచురాయి మోటార్ల షికార్లకు కుదుపొచ్చిందట రోచురాయి మోటార్ల షికార్లకు కుదుపొచ్చిందట పూలపాను పల్లె తోవగవినేడొస్తాడంట లాగరా హైలెస్స లాగరా రోడు రోలరు ముందడుగై సాగరా మారువాడి అప్పు కంటే మాయదారి బతుకు కంటే మారువాడి అప్పు కంటే మాయదారి బతుకు కంటే బరువా ఇంతోటి పెద్ద బండరాయి మావయ్యా లాగరా హోయ్ లాగరా లాగరా హైలెస్స లాగరా రోడు రోలరు ముందడు గై సాగరా లాగరా హైలెస్స లాగరా రోడు రోలరు ముందడు గై సాగరా మెతుకు విదిపితేనే తమ బతుకు పోయననుకుంటారు మెతుకు విదిపితేనే తమ బతుకు పోయననుకుంటారు బతుకే తమ బానిసని బానిసగా బతకాలంటారు లాగరా హోయ్ లాగరా పొలము పుట్ర అమ్ముకొని పొట్ట సీత పట్టుకొని వలసపోయింది దారిని పంట కాపు పట్నానికి లాగరా ఓయ్ లాగరా లాగరా హైలెస్స లాగరా రోడు రోలరు ముందడు గై సాగరా లాగరా హైలెస్స లాగరా రోడు రోలరు ముందడు గై సాగరా లాగరా హైలెస్స లాగరా రోడు లోలను ముందడు గై సాగరా
దిస్ ఇస్ అ వెరీ జెంటీల్ క్రౌడ్ ద నెక్స్ట్ సాంగ్ ఈజ్ మక్తూ మొహియుద్దీన్ Now this is a song which has a very interesting history on its own, but it also has, for me, a very, very personal story to tell. Makhdoom Sahab wrote this song. It's called Jaane Wale Sipahi Se Poochho, Wo Kahan Ja Raha Hai. He wrote it at the time of the Second World War. It is, I have heard this story from people who knew him, that he apparently wrote it when he was returning home from the railway station in a rickshaw, and he saw a whole group of very emaciated, poor people who had been conscripted to join the British Army. And he wrote this song when he saw their condition. Now, Makhdoom Sahab reportedly used to sing this song himself in a lot of the PWA and IPTA conferences, and perhaps he composed it himself. I don't know. I would be happy if anyone could give me more information about this. But this song, now a certain version of this was used in the film Usne Kaha Tha, which Salil Chaudhary had given the music to. And of course, the film version does not have the most radical paragraphs in it. And this was, of course, something that, a lot of poets did. They wrote two versions. They wrote relatively more sanitized versions for films and more radical versions which were sung outside. But this song, again, a certain version of it used to be sung by Ruma Guha Thakurta's Calcutta Youth Choir. But largely this song had been forgotten. And in the early 80s, I used to be part of a song group called Parcham in Delhi. And this song was taught to us by Safdar Hashmi. And so we had sort of just learned the song, and I used to sing it solo with a chorus, and we hadn't performed the song. In 84, after Indira Gandhi was assassinated and the pogrom against the Sikhs was unleashed in Delhi, Delhi was on fire, as were many other parts of particularly northern India, and there were several appeals that were being made to maintain calm. The people of the Sikh community were angry because there was barely any family which had not lost at least one male member in the carnage. And so there were several peace marches that used to be organized in Delhi after the carnage broke out. And one of those was organized in Delhi University, because Delhi University at that point was also a very, very volatile kind of a place. A citizens committee which organized the march, consisting of artists, academics, and various other people from different walks of life in the city, were taking the citizens march through different colleges and hostels of Delhi University, collecting relief as well as talking to students. And demonstration actually terminated in Khalsa College, which was one of the few places where Sikh men felt safe. And the atmosphere was extremely angry, on the brink of violence, and for good enough reason, a lot of young people from the Sikh community were wanting to just go out into the streets and confront whoever was out there to kill them. And so there were people who were trying to, pacify, and it was a very volatile atmosphere. And I was a young undergraduate student at that time in Delhi University, and Safdar whispered in my ear, he said, "Sing Jaane Wale Sipahi." And I turned around and I said, "But that's a song which is an anti-war song. Why should we sing it here?" He said, "Don't argue with me now. I'll explain to you later. Just sing it, please." And that was the first time Parcham sang that song. And I will never forget what happened then. I mean, it was, for me, it was my early experience with understanding what power music has, and how a song which was written for a completely different context, because of what it was saying about violence, resonated with another very similar, highly violent kind of a context. And people broke down, people went down on their knees. I mean, the atmosphere completely changed after that song, and then, you know, the public meeting could actually happen. So we'll now sing Jaane Wale Sipahi Se Poocho.
जाने वाले सिपाही से पूछो वो कहाँ जा रहा है, जाने वाले सिपाही से पूछो वो कहाँ जा रहा है। कौन दुखिया है जो गा रही है, भूखे बच्चों को बहला रही है। लाश जलने की बू आ रही है, जिंदगी है कि चिल्ला रही है। जाने वाले सिपाही से पूछो वो कहाँ जा रहा है। कैसे सहमे हुए हैं नजारे, कैसे डर डर के जलते हैं तारे। क्या जवानी का खून हो रहा है, सुर्ख है आँचलों के किनारे। जाने वाले सिपाही से पूछो वो कहाँ जा रहा है। गिर रहा है सियाही का डेरा, हो रहा है मेरी जान सवेरा। ए वतन छोड़ कर जाने वाले, खुल गया इनकलाबी फरेरा। जाने वाले सिपाही से पूछो वो कहाँ जा रहा है। जाने वाले सिपाही से पूछो वो कहाँ जा रहा है। जाने वाले सिपाही से पूछो वो कहाँ जा रहा है। जाने वाले सिपाही से पूछो वो कहाँ जा रहा है। Next is a poem from the contentious poet Faiz Ahmed Faiz, who he would not have imagined how famous he's become in India now after the Hum Dekhenge controversy. But what I'll probably sing Hum Dekhenge at the end if everyone thinks it's suitable. But before that, I want to sing a song. It's a poem which has not been composed into a song before. And for me, this is a poem that really epitomizes the creativity of people like Makhdoom Sahab and Faiz Sahab, which is that they were not uncritical and, you know, jingoistic radicals. They were asking questions of themselves. This is a poem called Ab Tum Hi Kaho Kya Karna Hai, Ab Kaise Paar Utarna Hai. Now this is a song that he wrote perhaps sometime in the 70s, towards the end of his life. And he wrote when he was not very sure about whether the politics that he had believed in for so long was really being able to provide any answers or not. And I think, especially in times where we might be complacent and we might be very, very sure about what politics means, it is prudent to also remember that we have to doubt ourselves. So this poem epitomizes that ability to doubt. Ab tum hi kaho kya karna hai.
अब तुम ही कहो क्या करना है, अब तुम ही कहो क्या करना है, अब कैसे पार उतरना है, अब कैसे पार उतरना है। अब तुम ही कहो क्या करना है, अब कैसे पार उतरना है, अब कैसे पार उतरना है। जब दुख की नदिया में हमने जीवन की नाव डाली थी, जब दुख की नदिया में हमने जीवन की नाव डाली थी, क्या कितना कस बल बाहों में, लहू में कितनी लाली थी। लगता था दो हाथ उठे और नाव पूरम पार लगी, ऐसा न हुआ हर धारे में, ऐसा न हुआ हर धारे में, कुछ मझधारे थी, कुछ माझी थे अनजान बहुत, कुछ अनदेखी पतवारे थी। अब जो भी चाहो छान करो, अब जो भी चाहो छान करो, अब जितना चाहे दोष धरो, नदिया भी वही है नाव वही, नदिया भी वही है नाव वही, अब तुम ही कहो क्या करना है, अब तुम ही कहो क्या करना है। अब तुम ही कहो क्या करना है, ये घाव कैसे भरना है, अब कैसे पार उतरना है।
There's been a lot of seriousness till now. But then Faiz Ahmed Faiz, Makhdoom Mohiuddin, they were both known for writing books, poems about mehnat aur mohabbat, dono. But not just them. What a lot of people who were growing up in the 80s and 90s with protest songs assumed was that the protest song has to sound like a protest song. And the protest song has to have certain keywords without which it doesn't become a protest song. But then if we look into the history of music which has been written about society, music with a conscience, music with politics, there have been lots of love songs as we know. And so the next song is a love song. It's in my language, Malayalam. It was written in the 40s and it was written for a play. And it is the love song being sung by a peasant girl to a parakeet. She says to the parakeet, "Will you come and sing in my banana grove? Will you come and sing in my green fields? Will you come and sing the song that will tickle the sickle that I hold in my hand? Will you come and sing for me?"
பச்சப்பனந்தத்தை புன்னார பூமுத்து பூநெல்லின் பூங்கரளே, உச்சைக்கு நீ என்று கொச்சு வாழத்தோப்பில் ஒன்னுவா பொன்னழகே. பச்சப்பனந்தத்தை புன்னார பூமுத்து பூநெல்லின் பூங்கரளே, உச்சைக்கு நீ என்று கொச்சு வாழத்தோப்பில் ஒன்னுவா பொன்னழகே. ki aaryan vittirinnu akkanam mamala vetti vayalaki aaryan vittirinnu akaryam kunninde aananda paattinde inamaanin kiliye inamaanin kiliye pachappanandathe punnara poomutte poonillin poonkarale uchekku nee ende kochu vaalathoppil unnuva punnalage pachappanandathe.
The next song is an Urdu translation of an English poem. I am part of a Indian South African music poetry ensemble called the Insurrections Ensemble, and we are a large group of musicians and poets from both India as well as South Africa, and we got together from 2011 onwards primarily in response to all kinds of events that were happening there as well as in India. And particularly in South Africa, there was a shooting of minors that took place in a place called Marikana, which, like with Jallianwala Bagh or what has happened in Delhi in the last few weeks, shook up the conscience of South Africans I think it was 2010 or 2011. So we came up with a set of compositions which were called Insurrections, and there were all kinds of compositions there, but I'm going to read out the English poem which was written by my colleague Ari Sitas, who's a South African poet and theatre person. It's called Flowers in Insurrection. It started from a butterfly spinning, once, spinning twice, dropping dead. I cannot remember lightning or thunder. All I remember is the lull. Water stood still. The drop from the leaky tap stood still. The tears from my eyes stood still. A chain of pearls in midair before the flowers burst the ramparts in what they called the insurgency of the flowers. They were everywhere, leaping from vases, snapping free from bunches, and there, flocks of jasmine, murders of hyacinth, parading up and down the emptying streets. The rumor spread to the trees and they bloomed. Roses conspired with almond blossoms. The Dangabani flower resurrected. The Kurinji blues intoned. And the secret ones of Katalamba of Himachal marched off the crevices in the arsenal, the orchid arrogant with a halo of bees. This was the English poem which was translated into Urdu by somebody who teaches in an Adivasi school in Madhya Pradesh. So I'll sing it in the translated version.
रगे आवाज़ mehroom ho jaye shahadat yun bhi hoti hai na koi abr gar ja tha na koi bark chamki thi mujhe bas yaad hai khamoshiyon ke baad khamoshi hawa thehri hawaon ne zameen ke baad baathre meri aankhon se nikle aansuon mein aasmaan thehre gulon ne jab गुलामी की सलीबे तोड़ कर फेंकी बगावत यूं भी होती है गुलों ने शाख छोड़े गुलशनों के दश्त में आए अमीने रंगो बूने खूं बहाकर कहर बरपाए कोई कीमत मरासिम की न कोई कदर जानों की शहर में हर तरफ लूटी गई असमत मकानों की कहीं नरगिस कहीं मरियम कहीं सुंबुल कहीं सूसन बगावत यूं भी होती है
गाना पड़ेगा आप लोगों को साथ में हम देखेंगे लाजिम है कि हम भी देखेंगे हम देखेंगे लाजिम है कि हम भी देखेंगे हम देखेंगे वो दिन के जिसका वादा है हम देखेंगे वो दिन के जिसका लाजिम है कि हम भी देखेंगे
लाजिम है कि हम भी देखेंगे के कोहे गरा जब जुल्मो सितम के कोहे गरा रुई की तरह उड़ जाएंगे रुई की तरह उड़ जाएंगे हम महकूमों के पांव तले जब धरती धड़ धड़ धड़केगी और अहले हकम के सर ऊपर जब बिजली कड़ कड़ कड़केगी हम देखेंगे लाजिम है कि हम भी देखेंगे हम देखेंगे लाजिम है कि हम भी देखेंगे हम देखेंगे जब अर्जे खुदा के काबे से जब अर्जे खुदा के काबे से सब बुत उठवाए जाएंगे हम महले सफा मर्दूदे हरम मसनद पे बिठाए जाएंगे सब ताज उछाले जाएंगे सब ताज उछाले जाएंगे सब तख्त गिराए जाएंगे हम देखेंगे लाजिम है कि हम भी देखेंगे हम देखेंगे बस नाम रहेगा अल्लाह का बस नाम रहेगा अल्लाह का जो गायब भी है हाजिर भी जो नाजिर भी है मंजर भी उठेगा अनल हक का नारा उठेगा अनल हक का नारा जो मैं भी हूँ और तुम भी हो और राज करेगी खलके खुदा जो मैं भी हूँ और तुम भी हो हम देखेंगे हम देखेंगे लाजिम है कि हम भी देखेंगे हम देखेंगे लाजिम है कि हम भी देखेंगे हम देखेंगे वो दिन के जिसका वादा है जो लोहे अजल में लिखा है हम देखेंगे लाजिम है कि हम भी देखेंगे हम देखेंगे हम देखेंगे हम देखेंगे
Thank you very much.